something that has been in my mind for a few years now. Something someone said to me, a relative actually, not just any old person, someone related to me. We had a misunderstanding some time ago because they were always asking me for money. So I got angry and said, why is it that you only call to ask for money, you only reach out to ask for money, but you don't care how I am doing, you don't care how I'm faring, you don't even know what makes me happy, what makes me sad, you don't know anything about me, all you know is just how to ask for money. It's not fair. It's not fair. At least be sensitive enough to ask how I am faring, not making me believe you only reach out to me because you need money. So if I didn't have money to spare, money to give you, you would not speak to me. You would never reach out to me, no matter what. This happened in 2018. So she got angry. She misunderstood it because I was saying it out of anger. I was angry. So she also got angry and misunderstood it, and we exchanged a few words. She insulted me, I insulted her back. She started the insult because she's older than I am, so she felt like I was talking to her in a bad way because I have money. So she got angry, insulted me, I insulted her back, and we ended the call. Now she immediately didn't even take up to an hour. I was still there where I was seated, wondering what just happened because I said how I feel, my own money again. Just expressed my feeling and it turned into a huge misunderstanding. Why? So I was there wondering what happened. I got an SMS. I opened the message and I read, I want to quote her. Now, the things she sent to me was because I had confided in her some time ago that I was trying to make conversation. I was trying to force myself on her, like make her have sense of, I want to feel a sense of belonging. Actually, I want her to show me that she actually cares more than the money that she keeps asking from me. So I brought up a conversation. I told her, because then I was just living with sound mind. We were not married. I moved in with him when I nearly met him. So we were living together. We've not gotten married. Then we got married in 2019, and this happened in 2018. So I was telling her that, Omo, that I can't wait to have a child. I cannot wait to have a child. That one of my happiest moments will be to have my own child. One of my happiest moments would be to have a child. You know, I was always telling her, she'd be like, oh, God will do it, oh, don't worry. And I'll say, oh, thank you. So every once in a while, I'll tell her, gist her. It was always me telling her things like that, so that expecting that she'd be asking me, how far, how are you? Or maybe sometimes send me a message to say, okay, that thing you told me, I'm putting you in my prayer, so it will happen, don't worry. You know, words of encouragement, you know, and then I didn't really take it that serious. I only said what I wanted. I didn't take it serious because then I've not gotten married. I was only living with a man, no marriage yet. So it wasn't really a big deal for me to have a child at that moment, but it was something I really wanted. I wanted in the near future. So that time now, when she sent the SMS, what she sent, she went and picked that thing that I told her. She said to me that I should have a child. Let her see. Let me quote what she said. She said, because of money, you're talking to me like this. Because of money, because I don't have. That is why you're talking to me like this. How much have you even given to me? What have you given to me that makes you talk to me the way you did? No problem. No problem. Maybe you want to have a child. You want to have a child, right? That was how she said this, right? With the question mark. Have a child, let me see. As long as I live, you will never have a child. Go and have a child, let me see. That child that you are wanting, that you really want to have, you will never have it. I got this after reading it. I was so shocked. I called her back. What is going on? I called her back to find out how did we go from 0 to 100, you know, from complaining that you only call to ask me for money to you telling me I would never have a child. You are related to me. This is not just like random Facebook person telling me these things. It is you that is related to me. You're my relative. She didn't pick my call. I replied. I sent her a message. I said, what is this? That this is so hurting. Why can you talk to me like this? This is harsh. Why are you talking to me like this? She replied again and said, I should watch. She She said I should watch that as if she doesn't know that I've scattered my womb, that I don't have a womb. Now, this is something that when they say it to me on Facebook, it's nothing. But when someone that is related to you says things like this to you, it hits home, it hits heavily. So I sat down there and I felt so bad. I thought about it, like, what did I do to this girl? That for her to, I thought the first one she sent was a mistake. She sent the second one telling me that I destroyed my womb. How? I've never gotten pregnant before. I've never done an abortion before. How did I destroy my womb? And she's so certain, saying it as if she was the doctor that did the whole procedure, that I would never have a child. Okay. I forwarded the text message to a few people, her siblings and some other people that we are all related to. And they were all telling me things like, why would she say? They didn't even still take it serious. Some of the people I sent it to, it sounded like this was a conversation they've had. So their reaction, they were like, now, wow. Anyway, move past it now. You know, you, Angie, you know, they carry things for mine. Forget it, she's just angry. They were making excuses for her. Nobody asked. Nobody wanted to know how it made me feel. Nobody wanted to, you know, nobody sided with me. I just don't want it to like look like a side thing. Nobody called it spade by its name to like say, what she did was bad. No. I waited for my husband to come back that day. And when he came back in the evening, I didn't want to forward the SMS to him, like munch and send to him, because he was busy. So when he got back, I showed it to him. He was so shocked. Like, this girl said this to you? This girl that you've been trying to help, that you've been giving money to? I said, yes, see what she said to me. Now, I couldn't let it go, sorry, let me not lie. It was so painful. That night I did not sleep. My husband tried to talk to me a lot of times to see if it would go out of my mind. I couldn't sleep. Then the next morning, I sent her a reply. I didn't block her. It was after sending her that message I blocked her. I sent her a reply and said, okay, you said that I would never have a child. As long as you live, I will never have a child. Now, let me tell you my own. I'm going to have a child. You're going to watch me get pregnant. In fact, you're going to be there. I will marry. And this is the same guy that I'm going to get married to. You'll be there. I will have a child. And you will be single. No man will look at you in the face. No man will ask you how far. No man will propose to you. You will not even have a boyfriend. You will not even be in a relationship. You will remain single. Watch me go through the process of marriage. Watch me get pregnant. Watch me have my child. This is what I'm telling you. Since you decided to curse me for doing absolutely nothing to you, this is my own curse. I'm countering it and I'm rejecting everything you said to me. I'm using it. I'm using that energy that you sent to me to tell you my own, and I'm countering the one you said. After sending the SMS to her, I blocked her. I blocked her number, WhatsApp, everywhere, SMS. I blocked the whole thing. Now we moved on. And it's so strange that after a few years, this thing happened in 2018. Then in 2019, she started trying to reach out to me through another relative's phone. I felt, okay, what happened has happened, because I'm not one to just carry things in my mind. But I will not lie, deep down, anytime they mention her name, anytime I come across her, anytime her thoughts just get into my head, I must... That thing is like in the background, it burns me. So when I got pregnant, I decided to just let everything go. I don't burn, I don't get belly. So this girl now, you know, whatever she said, whatever she wanted, thought she would happen to me, did not happen. I am pregnant. I gave birth. To cut the long story short, while I was pregnant, I unblocked her. I blocked her and told her that see, that thing you said to me in 2018, it really hurts me. But as you can see, you're not the maker of my life. You're not God of creation. I am pregnant and I'm happy. I'm happy in my marriage. I'm doing well. You know, I'm very, very, very successful. So I expected her to say she was sorry for what she did. Instead, she said, that thing has passed now, that she's not even thinking about it again, that she moved past it. Yo. I'm like, are you kidding me? Because I actually reached out to her to see, in the happiness of me being pregnant, to see if she would say she would genuinely apologize, so that I would also apologize for the reply I gave her, to take back my curse and everything. This girl did not flinch. She did not flinch. She said, it has passed. Just let it go now. Now, wow. I don't use this one. No, you move past it, Jerry. And please, I need money. Straight to money. I said, what do you need money for? She told me she wanted to start a business. She needs to rent a shop. She needs to do this, blah, blah, blah. I said, fine. That day, I gave her the money she wanted. I gave her money to start, get a shop. I paid for everything, a very good shop. I stocked up her shop for her. I started a very big business for her, a good one. I did not even, out of the happiness. And then I said to her that, Omo, I wish you well. Will you get married? Do you understand? But it's not that easy because she hasn't apologized. She did not apologize to me. So things like this don't just happen for me to take back my words. And do you understand? So she was just all after the money. This person I'm talking to you is not in a relationship. She doesn't have a boyfriend. No man has proposed to her. I don't know when she's older than me, way older than I am. She's still single. No sign of man anywhere. Not even the one saying being friends, just friends. Not, let's not even go fast into a relationship. Friendship she doesn't have. So I started feeling bad at some point. I called her again. I said, remember this thing you said? Maybe this is what she said. Lie. This and that is not the reason. And she'll get married. She knows she'll get married. I said, too, I'll be putting you in my prayers. Why I'm doing this thing is, this has become like, it's been in my heart like a burden. Something I felt like, it's only my husband that knows and the few people, like the few relatives. I decided to do this video to speak to someone because I know this situation, I am not the only person. It is not exclusive to me. I am not the only person that has experienced such a thing before. A lot of times I talk about my experience in trying to conceive before I got pregnant. It is because I know that someone out there needs to hear this thing. Someone out there needs to, I need to connect to someone to let the person know that whatever they say to you, whatever they tell you, the kind of courses they play to you does not and will never define your life. You own your life. You have control of your life. My father used to say in Igbo, Adona kono akolo, which in translation means, do not be like the curse they laid on you. Do not be like the insults they put on you. Do you understand? If somebody said, Omo, see this person is so poor, tfiakwa, don't try your best to leave poverty so that you will not be like that poor man they called you for a long time. No. You're trying to conceive and then there are family members on your back mocking you, if I'm turned into a form of ridicule, making caricature of you, insulting you, any small misunderstanding you have with someone, they strike you there, they tell you, look at you, you will never see you, you are a man, your husband married a man, go and give birth now, go and get pregnant, let's see, you can never get pregnant, this and that. It hurts you. It's painful. I will not lie. I won't tell you. It's painful. Sometimes you even cry. The one she told me, my relative told me, I cried. When random people tell me this is on social media, it doesn't hurt me because these people don't know me. They don't know me. They just want to throw me to make me feel bad because they see I am doing well. I am successful. It's like that. It's just jealousy. But when somebody that knows you, a relative tells you things like this, or a friend that is close to you, it is so painful. It's difficult to let go. Now, don't let this thing define you because you will get pregnant. There is no person that is barren. Delay is not barrenness. I got pregnant. I got pregnant September 2019. And it didn't even take up to 2-3 months after pregnancy. They started trolling me, dragging me, calling me barren, saying I had no womb. Just 3 months of marriage. Now, imagine people that have been in this situation for 5 years, 3 years, 10 years, no child. They are going through hell. They are suffering. When I say suffering, not anyhow. They are really, really suffering. So, I am speaking to such people now. Don't let this thing define you. If you see things you want to buy for your future child, don't wait. You have the money, buy it. Don't wait until you have a child. No, buy it and say, this is for, if you even have a beautiful name for your future child, for your future daughter, future son, name that, start calling it. Speak it into existence. When they tell you this thing, pick your pain. That moment you're feeling pain, use it to speak to the universe. Use it to speak out loud. Affirmation is when you bring forth positive things, as when you claim positive things loudly. Don't do it in like whisper in your heart or secretly. Speak it out. Like, you see this thing that you've used to insult me now, this thing that you're using to mock me. You'll be alive and see me get pregnant. You'll be alive and see me carry my own child. They've insulted me. They've mocked me. Everything they mocked me with, I achieved it beautifully. Everything they insulted me with, I achieved it 10 times over. Do you understand? Don't let what they used to insult to define your life. I know I know this is not easy. It will never be easy, you get, but in the end, you laugh. You're like, he who laughs last, laughs the best, because you have to pick up. You don't just fall and then lay down there because somebody is telling you you cannot get up, you cannot. No, try to get up. Prove to yourself, not to the world, prove to yourself that you can and you will. You will be a mother. I am speaking before. I used to say these things when I see people trying to conceive. I just look at them and say, I wish you the best. You get pregnant. No, until I walked in their shoe. If you've not been in these people's shoes, you would not understand what they are going through. Wherever you are, even if you're married or not married, you know anybody trying to conceive, give them support. Stop asking them when they will get pregnant. Stop using it to insult them. Stop calling them barren. Stop monitoring their womb. Pregnancy is something that does not hide. When it starts to show, you will see it. Pray for them. People will always be mean. Some people just want to hurt you. Some people just want to tell you words that will make you go and die. Especially, leave social media people, especially the ones close to you. That's what I'm talking about. Use that moment of pain to make affirmations. You will have a child, and a person born you now. You don't forget a person. How did you come into this world? Somebody gave birth to you. If you have a medical condition, go and treat it. If you have a medical condition preventing you from getting pregnant, go and treat it. But if the doctor has checked you and your husband and says, both of you are fine, you will get pregnant, there is no problem. You will conceive and you will get pregnant. Everybody mocking you will be alive to witness it. This year is coming to an end. 2022. Before you enter 2022, make affirmations. Sit down. Make a list of the things you want to happen to you in the new year. Make a list. Maybe it's next time when I do a video, I'll talk about how to make a list and how to positively make it, and then make it so that it will come to manifestation. Not just write, I want this, I want that. No, there is a passionate way you have to make a list that connects to your aura, connects to your spirit guide. Like, you're making it physically, it's also made physically, spiritually, so that it will manifest in no time. I hope this video connects to one or two people. I decided to share this, my true life story, because it's something that has bothered me. And to that lady, I always pray for her. I wish she gets married. I wish she'll just get married and have her own child. And I also wish she'll finally put pride aside and genuinely apologize to me for the things she said to me. I believe that her remedy, her solution starts from apologizing to me. So I'll apologize back and then let good things start happening to her. Thank you for watching.